I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana. You know, sometimes you got to put your thoughts down on paper or in a computer, and there are different ways to do that. Josh Anderson is going to show us a new thing called Inspiration Maps that helps people do some mind mapping activities. I think you'll find it's pretty cool. Let's see what Josh has.
I'm Josh Anderson, Assistive Technology Specialist with Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana. Today I'm going to show you an app called Inspiration Maps, which will help you get your ideas onto paper for writing large reports and other things that you might need for school. While this app is very effective for individuals who may have a learning disability, it's also really for anyone who really needs to just get their ideas out on paper. So let's take a look at it. All right, we're going to start with the Inspiration Maps app. We'll go ahead and get it open. Now, this is actually the free version. There is a paid version available for $9.99 if you have the free version. There's a few functions you don't get, and also this annoying thing will come up every time asking you to pay. So, whenever we first bring it up, we need to go back one. When we first bring it up, it has some different templates that we can try. Just different mapping for different classes, English by bibliographies, book and film comparisons, all different kinds of things. And I've already made up one here to just kind of show you some of the features and everything. So what it is, it's that old brainstorming thing that we were taught in English class when we were younger. So essentially we start with a main idea, go to smaller ideas, and on to smaller ideas and everything else. What's nice about this app is, though, you can really pull everything in to one spot. You can actually, as you can see, take a picture and put it on there. There's my smiling face. You can also record audio.
This is a planning map in order to make tech tips for two apps to help with studying.
And as I said, you can actually pull everything in. You can change the color, size, and shape of all your different pieces. You can add new pieces very easily. So this is what a finished one would look like, and I'll actually show you how to make this. But what's really nice about this is if you're using this for studying for a large paper, a large project, or something like that, after you map this all out, with the push of one button, you can change it all to just your normal outline form. You can then actually email this to yourself, or print it out if you like. And with the paid version, you can actually send it to Dropbox, to the cloud, and some other features that aren't available on the free version. So as we go back, we can go ahead and start a brand new one, just so I can show you how this works. So if I touch, actually let's start a brand new one. If it'll let me do it here. Start up a new diagram. It always starts off with a main idea. So, you know what? We're just going to actually call that main idea to make it nice and easy. And as I said, as we go up here, we can change all different kinds of things. We can go ahead and change the color, make it red, maybe to give us a little more information there. Change the color of the text, make it show up a little better. We can change the size of the text, change where it goes. And as I said, we can also go ahead and change how we design. And basically, you can change almost any of the settings that you like. Whenever you want to add another idea to it, we just touch a little arrow right here, and another box pops right out. Right in there, we can put our next idea by double tapping it and just typing it right in. So we'll just do that as next. We'll go ahead and get that off the screen so it's no longer in our way. And again, we could change the size and everything of that as well. We can touch a little button here and actually put an extra note on there for more information. Let me make that just a little bigger so it's a little easier to see. So these little notes are just for more information. We push a little X, they disappear and only pop up when we touch them. Now, there are actually more buttons up here at the top, little things that we can add. As I said, you can also go ahead and pull that in so that everything disappears, push it back out so it's a little bit easier to find everything. And again, it all just goes right back over to your main ideas into the outline form. As we go back in here, just a couple more features to kind of show you. If we go up here to to the info. We can go to audio, select where we want to put the audio, just press record, and this is just a test for a main idea recording. And go ahead and stop it.
Just press record, and this is just a test for a main idea recording.
And put that right back on there. If we don't like it, we can delete it. If we want to re-record, we just hit re-record. As I said, you can also change the way the diagram's set up. You can change the background color. You can even change the way that the arrows look. So it's a very good tool for studying, for putting everything together, and just for basically putting all your ideas onto paper for large projects and large papers. So that is the Inspiration Maps app.
So there's a handy way to get your ideas out in a different way and still be really productive with them. That's your tech tip for this week. I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana.